Sunwing 9644.
After a morning of fog, the metal is finally moving off the tarmac again on time.
But I want to get him closer to the gate.
It's another hectic shift at Nav Canada's Toronto Tower.
20 north is a 484.
And now this on the horizon. Severe thunderstorms tracking north of the country's busiest airport.
Alpha Tower 18.
More coming at controllers by the minute.
Taxi Mike, Tango, hold short.
It's time to switch runways for a few flights to stay safe.
For the west and left to right.
This isn't a snapshot of a full day here, just about 30 minutes.
It looks hectic out there. It looks stressful.
It is. There's a lot going on. There's an awful lot to manage.
And Tango's good?
It's the way they're managing that's different here, not just in the tower, but in the area control center next door, where thousands of flights a day tracking through North America get a safety escort on so-called skyways from controllers like Curtis Arnold.
At our busiest peak periods, we'll have a takeoff or landing at this airport every 25 seconds. So what's it like to work that? Well, there's a lot going on. You really train yourself to internalize the procedure. So you're making decisions sort of subconsciously because you're communicating constantly.
The result is an award-winning system ahead of the curve in technology and, in the opinion of the aviation industry, one of the best.
So while Nav Canada operates one of the most sophisticated air traffic control systems in the world, none of this is government-owned or operated.
We can demonstrably show that our system is safer today than it was when it wasn't government. Flights are shorter. People get more direct routings. There is very little delay in our system attributable to the air traffic control system. Very little, almost negligible.
Mismanaged by the government for decades, in 1996, Nav Canada was privatized, and it now runs like a business with a bottom line. Save one thing, any profits are plowed back into the business. The members that govern Nav Canada, the airlines, the government, employee unions, set it up that way.
The profits come in safety, they come in greenhouse gas efficiency, or our own cost improvements.
Things are done differently here, especially when it comes to the welfare of controllers. There is an open dialogue about stress, they say, and how to manage it. Everything from nutrition to exercise, and yes, break rooms with recliners where napping is allowed, even encouraged.
I'm just glad that we can. It's one of those things that really helps, especially on a midnight shift, being able to slip away and get 15 minutes.
Some people hearing this story might think it's too good to be true. We took it right out of the government's hands, put it into private industry, and it works perfectly.
Well, it's true.
They can believe it, you're saying.
They can believe it, and the facts speak for themselves.
And those facts, aviation leaders around the world are taking notice of Nav Canada, in some cases adopting its procedures, buying its technology, and taking its philosophy on board. Paula Newton, CNN, Toronto.